You might have heard the rumors. Google is banning site loading, but is that really true, or is there more to the story? Stick around, because what's actually happening affects every Android developer, open source contributor, and even you, the user who installs apps outside the Play Store. Before we continue, I want you to know that this channel is all about growing as software engineers together. If you want to join, subscribe now. Starting in 2026, Google is rolling out a new rule. Every Android app, even those installed outside the Play Store, must come from a verified developer. That means if you download an APK from the internet or from a third-party app store like F-Droid or Amazon App Store, Android will check. Has this developer registered and verified their ID with Google? If the answer is no, the app won't be installed on most Android phones. But here's the twist. Google insists this is not a ban on sideloading. They say it's about security, not control. Google claims that this move fights malware. They say phones that sideload apps from the web encounter 50 times more malware than those using the Play Store. So, to fix that, they are introducing this developer verification system, basically an ID check for anyone who publishes Android apps. According to Google, developers will still have the freedom to distribute apps however they want, as long as they've verified their identity first. Sounds reasonable, right? Well, not everyone agrees. Independent developers and open source projects are furious. Many developers don't want to hand over personal ID to Google, especially those who work on privacy tools, research projects, or volunteer open source apps. The team behind F-Droid, one of the biggest open source app stores, even said this change could end F-Droid as we know it. Why? Because thousands of small developers release apps anonymously for privacy or security reasons. If they don't verify, their apps will simply stop installing on most Android phones starting in 2026. That's why people are calling this the biggest blow to Android's openness since it was built. Let's break down who gets hit the hardest. Indie developers and hobbyists must now create an official developer account, submit ID, and register their app's package name with Google. Enterprise developers are mostly safe because internal company apps on managed devices are exempt. Third-party app stores like F-Droid and Amazon App Store must ensure all their listed apps are from verified developers. And for regular users, if your favorite app comes from an unverified developer, you won't be able to install it. So what does all this mean for the Android ecosystem? Technically, sideloading isn't gone. You can still install apps manually with ADB or on phones that aren't Google certified, like custom ROMs. But for most people, this makes Android feel like Apple's iOS. Critics say Google is becoming the gatekeeper of the entire Android ecosystem, even beyond the Play Store. And that could raise antitrust and legal questions, especially in the places like the EU, where the Digital Markets Act protects sideloading rights. In short, Google says it's about security, but many developers fear it's really about control. So what can we do as developers and users? Stay informed. The rollout starts in 2026, globally by 2027. If you're an indie developer, plan to verify early. If you care about open source freedom, support projects like F-Droid or Graphene OS that keep Android open. And most importantly, keep the conversation going. Actively participate on websites like Reddit to protect your sideloading rights. You can also launch an online campaign on platforms like change.org, because this policy might redefine what open really means for Android. So, what do you think? Is Google making Android safer or slowly turning it into another iOS? Drop your thoughts in the comments. I read every one of them. If you find this breakdown helpful, hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. See you in the next one.